Today we've got the new freezer to our lab, so we are going to substitute the old one. We've been monitoring the temperature and power consumption with iSocket. I already switched it off and plugged it directly, the old one, and here we are going to switch the new one. And also we are monitoring the temperature constantly with help of this temperature sensor. It was already removed from the old one, and I will show you on the chart, on the diagram, how you can notice this with the temperature rising. So we are going to put this to the new one, and we will be monitoring the temperature profile of this freezer. We will be looking how quickly it gets to minus 18. So the sensor will go inside from here, because I believe this is the best location where the pressure of the rubber sealing will not allow to cold leaking. So we have the sensor somewhere there. Well, let it be in the middle. And we have a tiny cable, which is 3 millimeter diameter here. So we don't have any leakage here, of course. And I believe we will not have a leaking here. However, I'm not sure, because the rubber on this specific model is quite thin. On the regular household fridge, you usually have it maybe like that, maybe like 4 millimeters, but here it's probably, well, I'm not sure, but I think it will be leaking. The leaking is bad for just one reason. That is the reason. Well, not the only one. Of course, power consumption will also increase. And that's what we are going to test as well, because we plug this freezer to iSocket with energy meter, and we will be monitoring how much power it uses over the time, and at certain moment we can also check this anytime through our dashboard. So it is up and running for the first time. And okay, colder. I believe somewhere here we will get minus 18, but we will see. So we keep it this way and we'll be looking on the chart what is happening there. I will share my screen to you this way, so you can see the old one was constantly keeping minus 20. And that's the moment when we removed the sensor and we've got this spike. And now it's going to be, and we received a notification about this, of course. So, and now it's going to be lower and lower, and we will notice in what time this will happen. By the way, let's put this thermometer inside. We have nice light here, so let's put it here to compare with the iSocket sensor. Then we should also place the iSocket one here, as close as possible to each other. That's fine for me, absolutely fine. Yeah, and continue our experiment. Okay, I'm going to select just one day here, view for another period, so that we have less data. on the screen, and it will be more convenient to look. Yeah, yes. Well, that is the old freezer, minus 20. Then that is the time when the sensor was removed, and now you can see a good chart that shows how long it took to get minus 24. Wow, that's a lot. So it was half past five, and now, so it took almost 2 hours to get to minus 24, and actually to minus 18 it took, well, about the same, couple hours. Let's look what we have inside the freezer with the regular thermometer, or just the simple one. Okay, let's check what we have here. So, is it true that we have minus 24? That is absolutely true. True, yeah, that is. Minus 24, exactly. Yep. So, it's too much. It's too much. Let's do the following. We put it there. On the bottom, both of them. And we reduce it. That's too much. So, I'm not sure. I should read the manual, actually. So, probably it should be mid. Let's keep it this way. And by the way, on the energy meter, we can see that it consumed 83 watt hours energy for 2 hours, which is about 40 watt hours per hour. So later by evening we do have the temperature we wanted, which is about minus 18 by adjusting the knob to middle, if I remember right. Yeah, so you can notice this is the place where we move from minus 24 to minus 18 on the bottom of the freezer. We will check it now. So that's how we see this on the historical temperature data. And we can see also this temperature here in the monitorings. We can see minus 18.7, which is right now, yeah. And we see that the freezer is switched off, no consumption. Okay, that's the moment where it's switched on. And you can see the current power consumption is 68 watts. So, isn't it wonderful? If you don't understand Celsius, I will switch to Fahrenheit for you. So, you can see it's minus 1.7, which is about the temperature you want to have in average in the freezer, if it's not for vaccine storages, of course. And let me then show you the diagram for historical data, the log, also in Fahrenheit. So, this is our old freezer. Yep. You can see the history of the temperature. That is the moment when we removed the sensor. So we have about the room temperature. It's hot now, even in Finland. And that's the moment. That's the moment when we have seen quite low temperature. And then when we put it to the middle, that's we have about zero Fahrenheit. Yeah, that's what you want to have usually in your freezer. So let's compare in Fahrenheit. We do have this on the bottom as we left it. And what do we see here? Here is no Fahrenheit, sorry. Yeah, but we can see this minus 18. Now you can't see anything. Wait a moment, please. Well, trust me, it was minus 18. That's all, guys. So I put it back here. I will do some more experimenting, and then I will put our valuable things to this brand new freezer. Smile, peace.